I know of no other happiness, nor have I ever witnessed it. The marvel of the way in the world, I thought that even if there were nothing, nothing more, the possibility of being would exist. I thought I had encountered permanence, miracle of substantial language, of clarity, and of respect. And whether they are beautiful or not, there will be no one to guard them in the days to come, and the handful of precious stones in our fields. Poor savages of ghost and glitter, merely rolling now. The tire leaves a mark on the earth, a ridge in the ground, crumbling at the edges, which is terror, the unsightly, silting sand of events, the poet wrote of, that we tried to break, each electron beating without cause. Savages, savages, there is no mystery about them, given the rest of it, and no one to shield them. Therefore, in the days to come, in the ruts of the road, but the God, they said, moving on the waters, on the shallows, of the unrolling of the universe, and indeed the people, stir in the mornings, coming from the houses and the black hair of the women at the pump against the dawn, seems beautiful. But the mind rises into happiness, rising into what is there.
There are things we live among, and to see them is to know ourselves, a currents, a part of an infinite series, the sad marvels. Of this was told a tale of our wickedness. It is not our wickedness. You remember that old town we went to when we sat in the ruined window? And we try to imagine that we belong to those times. It is dead and it is not dead. And you cannot either imagine either its life or its death. The earth speaks, and the salamander speaks, Arab, in dreams and images, and the pure joy of the mineral fact, if it is matter, is impenetrable. A populace flows through the city. This is a language, therefore, of New York.